Hello，大家好，我们继续做这个，这本课本里的练习题，第19课。好嘞，听你，我开始那个 MP3 给你听，稍等一下。
第十九课，
好嘞，
无阳光的深海世界。
开始打。
一、听力。第一部分，第一到五题，请选出与所听
听
内
内
容
容
一
依
致
据的
的意
意向，
象。现在 开
那个很
始
重要。
第一题。
好，老师，
一、青少年的兴趣爱好若能及早得到培养，就能表现出某一方面的才能。老师根据学生的爱好，有意识地加以引导，就会使学生在自己爱好的活动中发展特长，增长聪明才智，进而具有发现问题、分析问题、解决问题的能力。
OK，稍等一下。OK，so we're talking about teachers, like actively helping, like being aware of students' interests and actively helping them solve problems. 要善于帮学生解决问题。Maybe this one. 好，老师要能发现学生的问题，not just discover, but also solve the problems. 每个孩子都有自己的特长。老师要根据学生的特长加以引导。They didn't say that，加以引导。Yeah, let's do D. Not sure how to exclude the others, but I think the answer is D. 乌鲁木齐是新疆，是新疆的首府，
二，
首府。
七月份新疆出现异常高温天气，大部分地区最高气温在35摄氏度以上，一些地区的最高气温为40摄氏度以上。首府乌鲁木齐14日最高气温达到40.6摄氏度，突破近30年来最高气温历史极值。吐鲁番地区最高气温达到46.2摄氏度。
乌鲁木齐是新疆的首府，省会对吗？首府，what is 首府？I'm not sure. 乌鲁木齐 is the capital of 新疆 province, right? Don't know what the Chinese word is. It's 省会，right? 省会，what is 首府？What are the other ones? 在新疆，40摄氏度高温很普遍。This is not 普遍, it is. It's very cool. I mean, when I went to Urumqi, it was snowing. 七月份，新疆的天气反复无常。反复无常，it's kind of a contradiction, right? Repeatedly abnormal? If it's repeatedly abnormal, then that's the normal, right? 乌鲁木齐的气温高于吐鲁番。I don't know where 吐鲁番 is. I think that's probably the answer. There was a lot of temperatures mentioned in that speech. I didn't remember them all. Like 40.6或什么以上，40以下，45以上，blah blah 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 blah. Like I didn't catch every detail of every statistic. OK，每个人都向交际提出新要求。历史会记录社会的
三，
发展变化。
随着社会的发展，新事物、新概念不断出现，这些都会向交际提出新的要求。我们翻阅解放前的书报杂志，就会感到有些词语很陌生，有些格式很不习惯。社会的发展变迁必然会在语言的词汇里留下印记。
Okay, so we're talking about the evolution of languages. 语言会随着社会的变化而变化。This one，书面语口。So we're talking about languages in particular. So that really means to me that the answer is C. We're talking about words and languages and how they evolve over time. Yeah, I think it's C. All right, next. Okay, 林行止, 熊秉元, 小说作家。
今年读到了新近出版的《经济新观察》丛书中的林行止系列和熊秉元系列。林行止读书甚广，读他的文章犹如进入阿里巴巴的山洞，美不胜收。熊秉元善于从一些日常小事中总结出经济学精神，读来有滋有味。
All right, that was hard to keep up. But they're both authors, right? Oh, but they're not authors of novels. This one's not an author of novels. This was about economics. The first person, the Shu, 介绍了很多旅游景点. Is that correct? I'm not sure. Maybe I didn't hear. The second person's Shu Nei, 内容常涉及 经济新观察是一套经济学书籍。 Yeah, okay, let's go D. I'm not confident, but that's my best guess. Renee 是定居, 促进了人口的增加，农业的发展也促进了渔猎文明。从渔猎到农业，人类社会先是出现了半永久性的农牧业村社，之后有了定居的村庄。 但这种状况也未能持久，一旦地力衰竭或人口增长过快，整个村社就要迁移，或分裂成较小的组团，寻找新的驻地，以保证足够的耕地。All right. 人口迁移是为了解决耕地问题。人类定居从渔猎时期就开始。 Is that one right? 农业的发展, 也促进了渔猎文明, 促进了人口. Could be this one. Could be A. I don't know. I'm going to choose D. There's a lot of D's. But I'll put an A here. I might change my mind later on. All right. So here it is, the next one. I'll start the MP3.
第二部分，第六道十题，请选出正确答案。现在开始第六道十题。男的女演员。第六道十题是根据下面一段采访。
All right. 听说你是个美食家。
美食家谈不上，只能说我是一个对美食没有抵抗力的人。我的优点就是不挑食。你认为什么是美食？ 美食是可以让你身心愉悦的妙药。能说得具体点吗？ 在心情好的时候，疲惫的时候，或是悠闲的时候，享受一顿可口的饭菜，那一定是最幸福的时刻。看来吃什么在其次，只要能让你有愉快的感受，什么都是美食。可以这么说。
是也有例外，
对于我来讲，新疆的饭菜都是美味佳肴，因为我是新疆人嘛。还有南京算是我的第二故乡，我对南京美食也是爱得不得了呀。
对吃你有什么感悟？
俗话说“民以食为天”，吃对于每个人来讲都是生存本能。可是众所周知，吃给予我们的远不止于此。我更在意的是与家人、友人。 在吃的那个时刻，围坐在一起，暂时放下忙碌的工作，忘掉这样那样的烦恼，享受片刻难得的悠闲。平常你下厨吗？以前经常下厨，现在因为工作的关系，下不少了。其实我很享受烹饪的过程，能亲手为家人准备一桌饭菜是一件非常幸福的事情。虽然做不出用料复杂、精致无比的饭菜，色香味俱佳。 还是没有问题的。讲个关于你的吃的故事吧。要说就说与拍戏有关的吃，那是在拍摄特种兵的时候。这部戏主要讲的是女特种兵的故事，拍戏强度很高，体力消耗特别大。我们的阵容中女演员居多，女孩子嘛， 本来就喜欢吃一些零食和水果之类的东西。可是在系里我是教官，总操练他们，尤其不允许他们吃零食。每天女演员们顶着烈日做体能训练，还得忍受我的训斥。直到今天，我心里还对他们抱有歉意，觉得当时我丧失了一个男子汉对女士们应有的同情心。
六，在吃的问题上，男的是个什么样的人？
So he really likes food. 没有不爱吃的食物，对美食的要求很高，只吃自己喜欢的食物，对美食有奇特的标准。I don't know, really. This one? 没有不爱吃的食物， I don't think so. I'm gonna go B. Yeah, I didn't do very well this time. I didn't really understand much of that. It sounds like a simple topic, right? Food, that's the easiest topic. That's the topic you always talk about, but it wasn't a normal conversation. 美食是可以治病的。口味独特的是美食。
七，关于男的眼中的美食，下列哪项正确？
He talked about 新疆 and 南京 food. So I guess it's C. Again, don't know. Must remember to write the correct letters this time. Last video I made 3 mistakes. 太不可惜了。Just writing down the letter in the wrong box.
八，对于吃，男的有什么感悟？
什么感悟？吃是人生头等大事，吃能解决生存问题。吃能提供营养，保证健康，可以和亲友一起享受悠闲。Is it this one? He did mention it, but I don't think that's his particular stance.头等大事。Let's go A. He was a foodie, so it makes sense for A. This is definitely not the case of he says X, the answer you just find X. You have to infer. 男的历来就不愿意做饭，男的太忙，没学过做饭。
九，在做饭的问题上，下列哪项正确？
Is it, I don't know, it's C or D, isn't it? Let's just go C. Put in bracket D, but not sure.
十，关于吃的故事，下列哪项正确？
And 拍戏时，经常吃零食。No, it was the female actors. 女演员，怕胖，不敢吃零食。Didn't say that.男的看不惯女演员老吃零食，看不惯 maybe this one。 戏中男的不让女演员吃零食。 I'm gonna go C. Not sure. Alright, and now the next part.
第三部分。
So here it is.
第十一到十七题。
So we'll do the first
three. 请选出正确答案。
密码。
现在开始第十一到十三题。第十一到十三题是根据下面一段话。
So I get the feeling we're talking about technology here.
传统密码的缺陷是显而易见的。简单的密码依然是大多数人保护个人隐私的最常见方式。以人体生物特征作为密码，真的可以变为现实吗？回答是肯定的。距离我们越来越近的眼泪密码便是如此。由于眼泪作用于角膜的结果无法被复制，因此眼泪密码的安全性有了质的提升。眼泪密码之所以保密性强，是因为每个人的角膜都有独特的图像。和据此甄别不同的人，如果黑客偷取并使用某人上次使用过的数据，机器会认定其无效， 因为他懂得每次扫描结果都应该有细微的变化，这是因为角膜表面因有泪水而湿润，因此数据是实时改变的。还有科学家在探索声音密码，也有银行推出指纹密码，不过生物密码技术目前并不完全成熟，假如一个人的手指肿了，那么机器则无法识别出指纹密码。
十一，关于传统密码可以知道什么？
Oh, it's A. That was like the first sentence. 这点非常明显，简单可靠，易错作。
十二，关于眼泪密码可以知道什么？
眼泪密码安全性有待提升，可复制性差一些。I'm not really sure what 眼泪密码 is. What do you think it is? 数据会实时改变。黑客破解很容易。You think it's D? I don't know what 眼泪密码 is. I'm gonna go D, but I'm gonna put a question mark there.Because I do not know that that is the correct answer. Next, I'm not sure. Maybe the answer is 传统密码 or something. Which one is the best? I don't know. I don't know what they're going to ask. What's the question?
十三，目前已在银行使用的生物密码是哪一种？
生物密码是哪一种？生物密码，生物 organism. Oh, this is like.Biometric or something, biological password. Maybe it's this one? 传统传统 So they were talking about banks, so you're just putting your PIN number. I think it's 2-1. I don't know, just from living in China, they scan your fingerprint. That's your biometric password. Alright, so it looks like I need to pay attention to someone's age.No, 二十级一百多 or maybe a dynasty, the link.
No, 第十四到十七级是根据下面一段话
Season, oh wow.
蛤蜊身上长着像树木年轮一样的纹路，每成长一年，它就仔细地画上一道完美的圆圈。科学家们数了又数，身上有120多圈的蛤蜊并不稀少，也就是说，这些蛤蜊穿越了一个世纪，又健康快乐地生活了20多年。目前发现的最高龄的蛤蜊为507岁。想知道蛤蜊长寿的秘诀吗？夏天对许多动物来说都是最享受的季节，它们大口大口地吃东西，以保持正常的新陈代谢。夏季的美食足够丰盛，它们不担心会没有东西可享用。对于蛤蜊来说，夏季是最幸福的季节，他们要繁殖后代，要承担起做父母的责任和义务。他们没有过多的时间去享用美食，他们的生活简单而快乐。冬天到了，宝宝们长大了，爸爸妈妈也自由了。但这时候，草木枯萎，万物藏匿，蛤蜊吃不到多少可口的食物。好在，他们习惯了节省而优雅的生活。只要有一些东西吃，就足够满意和幸福了。正是这些高贵的品质，保证了蛤蜊的长寿。也许聪明的人类，这时你恍然大悟了吧？我们总能够从蛤蜊身上想到些什么吧？十四，目前发现最长寿的蛤蜊多少岁？
哦、oh, okay, then it's C. Right? What is 蛤蜊？Some type of animal? 蛤蜊 I'm pretty sure this is B.
对许多动物来说，夏天是个怎样的季节？
I think it's B. The answer for 16 could be 夏天 or 冬天, depends what question they ask.
十六，蛤蜊在什么时候繁育后代？
繁育后代， I don't know. Let's go B.17人類從格力身上能悟出什麼道理?人生都要追求優雅,父母必須對孩子負責。父母撫養孩子不容易,簡約的生活是最健康的。 I think D. All right. I don't know how well I did, but all right. I don't think I did fantastic. Okay, Yubing, let's see if we can find some errors. Zhong Dafu. Zhong Daifu. Ah, this Zhong is their surname, right? Zhong Daifu de Wei Sheng Shi Shi Jin Ni Zui Zui Zheng Gui de Ji Yi. Yeah, so. This is an issue, because I think I've seen something like this before, where 最什么什么的一, yeah, I've seen this sort of issue before, 最什么什么之一 being considered incorrect, even though everyone says that. 在我的记忆里,几乎每个冬天的晚上,奶奶都在灯下学习。Yeah, I think that's fine. 一个华丽的转身,她在近乎疯狂的掌声中 完美的结束了花样滑冰表演. That's fine, right? 结束了. Yeah, that's fine. So with a twist of her body, she completed her performance, her routine.
河水在阳光的照耀下闪闪发光.
没问题. 但河比以前 摘了很多, 没问题, 浪, 也没有以前大, 没问题. Yeah, I think this is the error. Like, this is not really an error. I do not think it's an error. But I'm choosing 最啪啪之一 because some stuffy linguist somewhere thinks this is an error. Everyone says this. 他是我最好的朋友之一, this sort of thing.
他被《时代》杂志将其列入，他被这个将20世纪最有影响的100个人
OK 列入 OK that's fine. This is wrong though, right?
被这个江琪.
Maybe this 江琪 you need to get rid of.
他被这个杂志江琪.
Oh no. So what is 琪? 琪 is some like off-screen entity. It could be a person. It must be a person, right? So this is a person. This 琪 is not him, right? Yeah, this doesn't make sense. Like, what? Who is this person? Who is the person listed here? Yeah, I think that's an error.
没有翻不过的高山,没有走不出的沙漠, 更没有超越不了的自我.
Yeah, that's fine.
蔚蓝的天空堆满造型奇异的云朵.
Dui man, yun duo. It's a bit weird. Using dui for yun duo. 有的像人，有的像动物，还有的像花。Alright, I think 堆 is a bit weird, but I think maybe that's just you need to be a little bit flexible. 韩信人游的护理护理液更容易渗透到受损的发丝中。Okay, so this is your hair. It permeates your damaged hair. 从内部对发丝进行修补。Okay, yeah, I'm going A. I can't make sense of this with the Bei and Jiang at the same time.香气 doesn't make sense to me. I can't make sense of that. 空气不仅有体积，而且它还有重量。不仅有体积，而且它还有它。Okay, first of all, if I was writing it, I'd delete the 它, but I don't think that counts as an error. 重量还有重量。It's volume and mass. Let's see what else we got. 写论文不仅要驳错误的观点，而且会借助先人的看法。I think that's fine. I don't see a problem there. 尽可能小犯错误，这是人的准则。Okay. 不犯错误，那是天使的梦想。I think that's fine. I don't see a problem with that. It's a bit weird with 准则, but yeah, I don't know. It's not really a principle.
大学过后，空气仿佛被过滤得干干净净。好，一切都变得那么纯洁而美好。
I don't see any problem with that at all.
空气
yeah. So I didn't see an error in any of them. I'll read it again.
空气不仅有体积，而且它还有重量。
Do you reckon that 它 is the issue? You shouldn't put the pronoun there? That's possible, but unlikely, I think.
写论文不要不仅要驳错误的观点，而且会借助先人的看法。
You reckon 看法 is appropriate, right? Not 观点，
论点。
I think 看法 is fine.
尽可能少犯错误，那这是人的准则。不犯错误，那是天使的梦想。
Okay, so I'm a little bit uncomfortable with 准则。
准则。
I don't think it's wrong. I don't know. Let's go A. Oh, I didn't read.
大学过后，空气仿佛被过滤得干干净净。没有问题。一切都变得那么纯洁而美好。
没有问题。I cannot see anything even remotely problematic with D. A, A, A. Really? Yeah, I don't think I got all three. But I can't see any problems with this, with any of these ones in the third question.
All right.
Yeah, the first one.This kind of 最什么什么记忆 I recall seeing somewhere, maybe it was me doing this in the past, that someone counted it as wrong. And then I Googled it and it's like, oh, this is debated. But I think generally normal, like everyday people, just use that grammar structure all the time.
板块地体学说板块地体学说什么什么乐地壳运动现象
So okay, 说明 I would say 说明 发现解释了发明了嗯，这不是 can't be 发明发明 is something done by humans 发现了学说学说 is like a doctrine or something so 解释 makes sense 讲现 doesn't make sense at all so maybe 解释 is the correct answer 证明地球是一个生机勃勃的星体它有着非常什么什么的新陈代谢活跃 is fine 复杂 works 活泼古怪古怪 was not appropriate here 古怪 is like eccentric it's a kind of negative word for describing usually people 有着什么什么的过去和灿烂的未来辉煌 yepThat's what you describe, a glorious past. 广阔广阔 cannot describe the past. 惊人 sort of, but not really. 光荣光荣 also glorious. 光荣 but usually 光荣 describes achievements or something. 光荣 yeah, it's A.Too many A's. 什么什么的采访时间一过大半。OK, 计划的。预测 oh, sorry. 预测。预测 no, 预测 it refers to measurement. 预定预定 works. 算的。It's a bit inappropriate. A bit too casual.桌上的那杯茶未动我什么什么之周先生我看着我注意神事凝视 This one's good 注视注视 not so appropriate 注视 This is like notes or something You put it in your Actually, 注意 is that. You put it in your textbook, your textbook marginal notes. 凝视 works. 他全神贯注谈话仍旧有挑不完的进行着没有混乱没有迷惑没有顾虑没有跳跃跳跃 doesn't make much sense. 没有停顿OK, 谁也无法什么什么这位科学家严谨的思维。就是断绝。打断。Maybe 打断 is a better choice here. 拒绝 refuse.Stop. So stop is when usually when an entity stops by itself or voluntarily. Can you stop something else using 停止? I'm not so sure about that. 断绝断绝断绝 is not appropriate. It's kind of like wipe out or crack down upon or something like this. I don't think it's appropriate. So let's check D. 拒绝他的思维 I don't think that's appropriate. 停止 is also a bit weird. 预测 is out. 打算 is a bit weird. 停止 I don't think works like that. So D, 预定 So can I put 预定 here? 预定的采访时间已经已过大半。预定 So predetermined, pre-locked in.That makes sense. 我注视着周先生。Yeah, I think that makes sense. 注视 just like looking at where long over time. 没有混乱。他全神贯注。谈话仍旧有条不紊的进行着，没有混乱，没有停断。谁也没法打断 Yeah, the hard one is the most appropriate for the last one. So I'm going D. Next. Okay, 什么什么不要因为矿物质在人体内含量极小就 blah blah. Okay. Okay, 千万 works. 总之 could work if it was at the end of a text. 据悉 maybe. 偏偏 no, not really. 偏偏 I can't think of a use where 偏偏 would work. So I think 偏偏 is out. 含量极小就什么什么它的价值 就是低估 or something like that. 轻视 works. What's that? 漠视 I don't know this word. 忽视 that works. 小看 that works. I don't know this word. 须知他们对维持人体中的一些决定性的新陈代谢是十分必要的 什么什么缺少 or maybe it's like 假如果果然 缺少了这些必须的微量元素 OK 人体就会出现疾病 yeah, 一旦 is the most appropriate here 什么什么激起生命 甚至激起 yeah, 甚至 is the most appropriate here as well 哪一句 no, 甚至 is the best 千万 is excellent, is an excellent choice here 不是 yeah, OK, it's C Okay, A, 总之 doesn't work. 与其不如,与其宁愿. No, it doesn't work. 一致 kind of works, but it should be the other 句. 据悉 kind of works, but yeah. 偏偏 is out. 果然 yeah, 果然 yeah, no. Yeah, all right, I'm comfortable with those ones. All right, this one. This is the one I don't really enjoy doing, but I prefer the Yubing questions. 苍蝇是声名狼藉的逐臭之父。凡是脏兮污秽的地方都有它们的踪迹。 苍蝇的嗅觉特别灵敏 Alright, so we have a comma. We want to fill it in with something that refers to the sense of smell of a fly.
根据苍蝇嗅觉器官的结构和功能
No, not this one because you need to continue the sentence. And there's a full stop at the end of the sentence.
远在几千米外的 气味也能 嗅到
It's still a verb
闻到
对吗 It's this one, right? It's B
但是苍蝇并有了鼻子，并没有鼻子，真的。 它靠什么来闻呢？ 原来苍蝇的嗅觉感受器分布在头部的一对触角上。 每个触角有一个鼻孔，与外界相通，内含上百个嗅觉神经细胞。 All right, new sentence. 什么什么什么什么？这些神经会
Okay, so we need to talk about nerves. Could be A. 用来检测舱内气体的成分。 No, this tongue is like on a ship or a boat or something, so we're completely different topic. No, it's going to be the last one probably. 而是活的苍蝇若有气味进入鼻孔。 Maybe this one looks promising because it says 鼻孔 here as well, right? 若有气味进入鼻孔，这些神经会立即把气味刺激转变成神经电脉冲。 Okay, I'm happy with the E. Where are we? Here? 送往大脑，大脑根据不同气味物质所产生的神经电脉冲的不同。 Presumably 电脉冲 is something like electrical impulses, something in that ballpark. 就可区别出不同气味的物质。因此苍蝇的触角像是一台灵敏的气体分析仪。Okay, 仿生学家。So we encountered this in the textbook. Where was it? Oh no, it was in a previous question. The modeling organisms.
仿生学家由此得到启发什么什么什么什么。
Okay,
用来No? Okay. 根据苍蝇嗅觉器官的结构和功能仿制出一种十分奇特的小型气体分析仪。
Yeah, it's absolutely A.
这种仪器的探头不是金属，也不是，而是活的苍蝇。
Yeah, all right. That one was easy. You didn't even have to read that one. 就是不是，而是。And the, yeah, the last one was the one about the cabin. We'll just fill it in. See. Yeah, absolutely. Very confident with these answers.
就是把非常纤细的微电极插到苍蝇的嗅觉神经上，将引导出来的神经电信号经电子线路放大后传送给分析器已经发现气味物质的信号，便能发出警报。这种仪器已经被安装在宇宙飞船的座舱里，座舱里。
So spacecraft. So the cabin was on a spacecraft.
Where are we here? 用来检测舱内气体的成分。这种小型气体分析仪也可测量潜水艇和矿井里的有害气体。
Yeah. Okay, that's really an interesting article as well. Using flies to detect poisons in the air.Like a canary in the coal mine, but it's a fly, not a canary. There's some tall trees.
活化石
Yeah, living fossils. So presumably these trees are a living fossil.
活化石指先发现化石再发现活体或活体与确认的化石属同一种且同时存在。
So basically something that goes back to ancient times but is still alive kind of thing. Or something we thought of as fossils is like, oh, there's one over there. 于是，就有了一些延续了上千万年的古老生物，与其同时代的其他生物早已灭绝绝灭绝灭绝灭绝灭Usually it's 灭绝 but this is 绝灭 I didn't realize. 只有他们独自保留下来，适应了现代的环境，生活在一个极其狭小的区域，被称为活化石。OK， 1938年在非洲东南部的东南部海中发现的 OK， 毛尾鱼，毛尾鱼。So some sort of fish in South Africa? No, in Southeast Africa. 在世界闻名的一种活化石。中国的银杏树。水杉哺乳动物大熊猫，中华whatever that is, is it? I think that's the word for cod or something in Chinese, some sort of fish. 中华鲟，均被世界公认为珍贵的活化石。银杏树又名白果树。古又称鸭脚树或公孙树，原来2亿7千多万年前 So that's a long time, right? 2亿7千多 So this is like 100 million years, right? Something in that ballpark? I'm not sure if I get the numbers right. I get these mixed up.银杏的祖先就开始出现了，到了1亿7千多万年前，银杏以和当时称霸世界的恐龙一样遍布世界各地，后来绝大部分银杏像恐龙一样灭绝了。All right. 只有中国部分地区保存下来一点点，流传至今，成为稀世之宝。OK， 植物中的熊猫之称。Okay, so the panda of the animal world. 水杉树，姿优美，树叶繁茂，叶色多变而独具一格，它曾广泛分布于北半球，但经过第四纪冰期以后
So there was an ice age in the 4th century.
他们几乎全部绝灭。20世纪40年代，科学家在中国的四川、湖北和湖南均发现水杉尚有留存，其后这个曾被认为早已在世界上绝迹的树种迅速传播于世，水杉
杉 is like what is it, cypress or something? No, it's I forget. It's this one, right?
水杉不仅是珍贵的活化石，而且它有很强的生命力和广泛的 广泛的活应适应性，它生长迅速，是优良的绿化树种。现在不但在中国各地广泛栽培，世界很多国家也争相引种，使这珍贵的树木得以在全球范围内生生不息。OK, what is regarding living fossils, fossils that are still alive, what is true?OK, 先发现化石再发现活体。Maybe. 化石与活体同时被发现，对生存空间没有特殊要求。No? 是活了上千万年的动植物。Could be that one. So, I don't think it's necessary that the fossils were found first, like the actual fossils were found first. 发现化石。Maybe it is that. 只先发现化石再发现活体。Okay, so science has found, finds like fossilized fossils and then realizes, oh wait, they're still alive. They still exist. So it is A. Why is it not this one?That's not the definition, I guess that's the logic. Yeah, that's a bit different, isn't it? Alright. 银杏树古代又称为 Is it this one? 鸭脚树That's the only one I saw. The others just didn't happen, right? Just, they didn't mention it. It's there somewhere. We're talking 古代. So, where are we? Here? Somewhere there, wherever it is. 鸭脚树 duckfoot tree. Why is it called that? I don't know.银杏树的繁盛时期在现在对吗？应该是现在。So, alright, we have to look at these ludicrous numbers. 恐龙灭绝的时候 ，No, when the dinosaurs were still alive. Oh, these numbers. Alright. Okay, 繁盛时期。这个称霸世界的恐龙。So when is it? E 七千多万年前。银杏的祖先 ，Yeah, this is the start, so it's not that one. 到了一亿七千多万年前 ，I guess it's this one. 一亿七千多万年前 ，Oh my, this is a crazy question. Yeah, it's not this one. It's just not that one. But I think the better answer will be 现在。水颤的特点是 Oh, maybe it's 水颤水颤 Yeah, no, 水颤的繁盛时期 is now. I said the wrong thing then, not this one. 适应环境的能力很强对 they said that. Yeah, 水颤不仅 blah 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 blah, 而且它有很强的生命力和广泛的适应性。 Yeah, this one. 像速度慢于其他树，在世界各地均有发现。仅可栽种于中国南方。No, it's been transported to other ones. So it is A. Write down the right answer, Becky. Wherever last time. The last video, I just wrote down the wrong answer 3 times. It was embarrassing. Not because I misunderstood, I just wrote down the wrong letter. 5年前，一位老人的在海边发现了一只浑身覆盖着油石油，饿的也奄奄一息的企鹅。Yes, I've encountered this character. I know it exists. It's like suffocating or something like this. I think if I remember correctly. 老人把企鹅带回了家，给它取名。Dindum. Which country are we in? I don't know. Are we in like New Zealand or something? Dindum 是一只麦哲伦企鹅。之所以叫麦哲伦企鹅，是因为著名航海家麦哲伦于1519年。最早发现了它。Okay, Magellan penguin. 后来科学界就以麦哲伦命名该物种了。这种企鹅主要分布于南美洲South America 南端海域的群岛中。是温带地区企鹅类中极具代表性的物种。Okay, so it's in South America, right? In the warmer areas? 温带。It's like not warm, but subtropical, right? 老人给丁丁亲昵请你沾附在羽毛上的油渍，使它身上不再有难闻的气味。喂鱼给它吃，让它尽快强壮起来。有了老人的悉心照料。丁丁很快得以健康。老人把他带到海边。想让他回家，丁丁却没有走。他在老人身边整整待了11个月。直到他开始换毛才离开。换毛 is molting. Birds do that. They lose their feathers. I didn't realize penguins did that though. Replace them with new feathers. 老人本以为这辈子不会再见到丁丁了。令他诧异的是，几个月后丁丁又回来了，而且大模大样的跟着老人回了家。更为奇妙的。是，此后每年的6月，丁丁都会如期出现。每年的2月，再回到阿根廷和智利的海岸，而他每年来看望老人，要游行的距离超过3000公里，很厉害的企鹅。老人说，丁丁与他越来越亲密。每年他们一相见，丁丁就会愉快地摇晃尾巴，发出欢快的叫声。老人也像爱自己的孩子一样爱着丁丁。 他相信丁登也爱他，因为丁登 喜欢戴在老人的腿上，等着老人给他喂食，还允许老人把他抱起来。除了老人之外，任何人想接近丁登都会被咒 picked， 就是咒或臭 something like that. I don't know. I know the meaning of the character. I don't know its pronunciation. 丁登为什么会和老人这么亲近？这么亲近？还要每年不远万里来和老人团聚。有生物学家认为，可能是企鹅把老人当成了家人，也可能是丁登认为老人也是一只企鹅。至于真相，只有企鹅能够告诉你。Really? 五年前老人发现企鹅时，那是企鹅饿得没有了呼吸。This one maybe， 身上已开始换毛，身上沾满了石油。Definitely this one，非常想有一个家。B， body was covered in oil， 沾 what is 沾？ I don't know， steep like soaked in oil or something like that。关于麦哲论。企鹅名字的来源，下列哪项正确？救了丁登的老人给起了错，以企鹅栖息地的地名而命名错，发现这一物种的人给起的错，以最早发现人的名字而命名。Yeah, D. Named after Magellan. But Magellan didn't choose the name himself. 老人认为，最奇妙的事情是，丁登康复之后，一直没有离开他。对，no, that's not 对 is it? 一直没有。No, that's not correct. Didn't left, but came back. 丁登大大方方跟着老人回了家。每年六月，丁登都会准时来看他。Could be this one. 丁登居然能够有3000公里的距离。居然。So we need to think of the thing that makes this person surprised. So I think this is not what makes... It's true, but it doesn't make the 老人 surprised, right?更为奇妙的是，此后每年的六月，丁登都会如期出现。Yeah. So it's C. All right, and the last one, 关于企鹅，为什么会和老人这么亲近？下列哪项正确？谁知道？需要问企鹅。老人行事风格很像企鹅。错，这个答案只有企鹅知道。Yeah. See. That's what the last sentence was. 老人把企鹅当成了孩子，别人的亲近让企鹅不愉快。不愉快。All right. So that's the writing section done. I say writing section, and by writing section, I mean reading section.And we'll go check these answers. Yeah, I didn't do very well in the listening section. I think I did all right. I did as well as I can in the writing section. Start the MP3 again.
第十九课，无阳光的深海世界。一听力。
I chose D D C D D.
第一到五题，请选出与所听内容一致的一项。现在开始第一题。一，青少年的兴趣爱好若能及早得到培养，就能表现出某一方面的才能。 老师根据学生的爱好有意识地加以引导，就会使学生在自己爱好的活动中发展特长，增长聪明才智，进而具有发现问题、分析问题、解决问题的能力。
Hold on. So, yeah, so this is not, B is not correct because the teacher should encourage the student to find their own problems, right? Discover their own problems. I think it's this. But 特长 here is their 兴趣爱好. All right.乌鲁木齐 I chose D here. 乌鲁木齐的气温高于吐鲁番。Let's see if they say that.
7月份新疆出现异常高温天气，大部分地区最高气温在35摄氏度以上，一些地区的最高气温为40摄氏度以上。首府乌鲁木齐14日最高气温达到 40.6 摄氏度，突破近30年来最高气温历史极值。吐鲁番地区最高气温达到 46.2 摄氏度。
Okay, they didn't say anything about D. So it's not D. So it's not D. Then what is it? 乌鲁木齐是新疆的首府。They just didn't say anything like that, right? 在新疆，40摄氏度，高温很普遍。Maybe it's that 七月份，新疆的天气反复无常。Okay, I'm gonna change it to B. And let's put C. But it's definitely not D. C in brackets, and that's...Makes me feel better if I get it wrong. Probably will get it wrong. Here I chose C.
Three. 随着社会的发展，新事物、新概念不断出现，这些都会向交际提出新的要求。我们翻阅解放前的书报杂志，就会感到有些词语很陌生，有些格式很不习惯。社会的发展变迁必然会在语言的词汇里留下印记。
Yeah, I chose C, but 交际提出新要求。Yeah, it could be A.
四。
今年读到了新近出版的《经济新观察》丛书中的《林行止系列》和《熊秉元系列》。林行止读书甚广，读他的文章。犹如进入阿里巴巴的山洞，美不胜收。熊秉元善于从一些日常小事中总结出经济学精神，读来有滋有味。
What I choose? I chose D. 经济新观察是一套经济学书籍。I don't know, I feel like I'm missing it. I don't think the answer is D. It's not that it's been excluded, it's just that they didn't say that, right? It's definitely not A. 介绍了很多旅游景点。Did they say that? I don't know, I just don't know the answer. I'll just leave it, and I probably should get it wrong. So I don't know the answer. Here I chose D, put in brackets A. 人类定居从渔猎时期就开始了。
五，从渔猎到农业，人类社会先是出现了半永久性的农牧业村社，之后有了定居的村庄，但这种状况也未能持久。一旦地力衰竭或人口增长过快，整个村社就要迁移或分裂成较小的组团，寻找新的驻地，以保证足够的耕地。
It could be C. 迁移是为了，是为了解决耕地问题。Yeah, I think it's C. Neither of those. Yeah, you can tell. I'm not confident. When I'm going, oh, that. Yeah, it's like, no, I did not do well. Listening is absolutely my weakness. So, all right. Oh, sorry, I'll get the next MP3 going. This is the interview. I chose BCACC. But let's see if I want to change it.
第六到十题是根据下面一段采访。听说你是个美食家？
美食家谈不上，只能说我是一个对美食没有抵抗力的人。我的优点就是不挑食。
你认为什么是美食？
美食是可以让你身心愉悦的妙药。
能说的具体点吗？
在心情好的时候、疲惫的时候或是悠闲的时候，享受一顿可口的饭菜，那一定是最幸福的时刻。
吃什么在其次，只要能让你有愉快的感受，什么都是美食。
可以这么说，可是也有例外。对于我来讲，新疆的饭菜都是美味佳肴，因为我是新疆人嘛。南京算是我的第二故乡，我对南京美食也是爱得不得了呀。
对吃你有什么感悟？
俗话说，民以食为天，吃对于每个人来讲都是生存本能，可是众所周知，吃给予我们的远不止于此。我更在意的是与家人、友人在吃的那个时刻围坐在一起，暂时放下忙碌的工作，忘掉这样那样的烦恼，享受片刻难得的悠闲。
平常你下厨吗？
以前经常下厨，现在工作的关系下厨少了。其实我很享受烹饪的过程。能亲手为家人准备一桌饭菜是一件非常幸福的事情，虽然做不出用量复杂、精致无比的饭菜，色香味俱佳还是没有问题的。
讲个关于你的吃的故事吧。
要说就说与拍戏有关的吃，那是在拍摄特种兵的时候，这部戏主要讲的是女特种兵的故事，拍戏强度很高，体力消耗特别大。我们的阵容中女演员居多，女孩子嘛，本来就喜欢吃一些零食和水果之类的东西，可是在戏里我是教官，总操练他们，尤其不允许他们吃零食。每天女演员们顶着烈日做体能训练，还得忍受我的训斥，直到今天我心里还对他们抱有歉意，觉得当时我丧失了一个男子汉对女士们应有的同情心。
六，在吃的问题上，男的是个什么样的人？
没有不爱吃的书，对美食的要求很高 ，maybe。只吃自己喜欢的食物，对美食有奇特的标准。Not really. What did I choose? None of them really struck me as obvious. I chose B. Yeah, I don't know. I just don't really know. 美食是可以治病的，错。口味独特的是美食。家乡的食物是美食。
关于男的眼中的美食，下列哪项正确？
Yeah, it's gonna be this one, right? So I chose C, yeah. Okay, 吃是人生头等大事。I think this one's D, actually.
八，对于吃，男的有什么感悟？
He does mention about eating with friends and so on. 享受悠闲 and relaxing.男的历来就不愿意做饭。
九，在做饭的问题上，下列哪项正确？
男的太忙没学过做饭。Well, I chose C and put in brackets D. 非常将就用量。No, I don't think I get a better answer this time.
关于吃的故事，下列哪项正确？
I chose C. 男的看不惯女演员都老吃零食。No. 女演员 怕胖，不敢吃零食。No, they liked eating the junk food. 戏中男的不让女演员吃零食。No. All right. That's the best I can do, I'm afraid. I'm not going to do any better. I didn't change very much. I changed three of my answers. So that gives you an idea of my confidence level. All right, the next MP3.
第三部分，第十一到十七题，请选出正确答案。
Okay, I chose ADD. This one I was unsure about.
第十一到十三题。
What is 眼泪秘密？密码。
第十一到十三题是根据下面一段话。
传统密码的缺陷是显而易见的，简单的密码依然是大多数人保护个人隐私的最常见方式。以人体生物特征作为密码，真的可以变为现实吗？回答是肯定的。距离我们越来越近的眼泪密码便是如此。由于眼泪作用于角膜的结果无法被复制，因此眼泪密码的安全性有了质的提升。眼泪密码之所以保密性强，是因为每个人的角膜都有独特的图像。扫描仪和据此甄别不同的人。如果黑客偷取并使用某人上次使用过的数据，机器会认定其无效，因为他懂得每次扫描结果都应该有细微的变化。这是因为角膜表面因有泪水而湿润，因此数据是实时改变的。还有科学家在探索声音密码，也有银行推出指纹密码，不过生物密码技术目前并不完全成熟。假如一个人的手指肿了，那么机器则无法识别出指纹密码。
十一，关于传统密码可以知道什么
？Okay, this is absolutely A. That one's probably the easiest question there. Here I chose D, but it's wrong. So they, I feel like I understood this 眼泪密码 a lot better now. It's like those, like, I don't know, it's a password that uses your eyes and the film on your eyes, and it's every time it's scanned, it's supposed to be different. And if you reuse the same password, then it's detected as incorrect. So this is a problem with, like, fingerprints and so on. If someone gets your fingerprints, they can log into your phone and so on.
12.关于眼泪密码可以知道什么？
安全性有待提高，错，可复制性差一点。数据会实时改变，对，就是这个。
十三，目前你在银行使用的生物密码是哪一种
？Yeah, it's okay. Hold on. 12 is C. Let's.Four changes. Okay, so yeah, they said people are not familiar with the 声音密码, so just saying something, I guess. And banks are using 指纹密码. I know this also because I live in China, and that's what they use. So yeah, this one was tricky. Especially this one, was it 夏天冬天? And they use 夏季 just to make it even trickier, right?
第十四到十七题是根据下面一段话。蛤蜊身上长着像树木年轮一样的纹路，每成长一年，它就仔细地画上一道完美的圆圈。科学家们数了又数，身上有120多圈的蛤蜊并不稀少，也就是说，这些蛤蜊穿越了一个世纪。又健康快乐地生活了20多年，目前发现的最高龄的蛤蜊为507岁。想知道蛤蜊长寿的秘诀吗？夏天对许多动物来说都是最享受的季节，它们大口大口地吃东西，以保持正常的新陈代谢。夏季的美食足够丰盛，它们不担心会没有东西可享用。对于蛤蜊来说，夏季是最幸福的季节。他们要繁殖后代，要承担起做父母的责任和义务。他们没有过多的时间去享用美食，他们的生活简单而快乐。冬天到了，宝宝们长大了， 爸爸妈妈也自由了。但这时候草木枯萎，万物藏匿，蛤蜊吃不到多少可口的食物。好在他们习惯了节省而优雅的生活，只要有一些东西吃就足够满意和幸福了。就是这些高贵的品质保证了蛤蜊的长寿。也许聪明的人类，这时你恍然大悟了吧，我们总能够从蛤蜊身上想到些什么吧。十四，目前发现最长寿的蛤蜊多少岁？
Yeah, that one. Definitely C. I got that one right, I think. They did just say that. The trick was that they said a lot of numbers and you could get them mixed up.
十五，对许多动物来说，夏天是个怎样的季节？
Definitely B. They eat a lot in summer. Which is unlike me, I eat a lot in winter. here I chose B and I'm pretty confident that's correct too.
16. 蛤蜊在什么时候繁育后代？
Yeah, 繁育后代, like breed and give birth, right? It's summer. They were unlike the other animals. What is 蛤蜊anyway?
17.人类从蛤蜊身上能悟出什么道理？
I chose D. 简约的生活是最健康的。父母抚养孩子不容易，父母必须对孩子负责，一生都要追求优雅。I'm going to leave my answers alone. Okay, what is a 蛤蜊? I don't know what a 蛤蜊 is. 蛤蜊。Oh, it's a clam. I do know what a 蛤蜊 is. Yeah, this is a 蛤蜊. Okay. 蛤蜊. It's this. So this is what we're talking about. all right. And what was the other one? Yan lei. Yan lei mi ma. Yan lei mi ma. Yeah, crying password. Yeah, name, I don't know how to make sense of that. Okay. Anyway. Gully. Clam. I figured it was some species of animal, but I couldn't figure out which animal. All right, here are my answers. Let's lock them in and let us do the checking thereof. I'm not sure how well I did, especially in the listening section. You can tell there's lots of changes. If there's lots of changes, it means I'm not very confident. There are the answers. D, A, C, D, C. Whoa. C, D, C. After correction, I got this one. That one, I wasn't even in the right ballpark. A, C, D, C, D. A, C, D, C, B, B, D. All right, so after the changes, I did all right. Okay, A, A, B, A, D, C, B, A, B, E, A, D, C. Four. Oh, male talk. I read the wrong line. I read this one. A, B, D, A, B, D, C, C. Okay, I only got one wrong in the reading section, and that was in the Yubing section. Oh, that's the one I couldn't actually find where the error is. all right, that's pretty decent. I'm happy with that. A, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, wow, I was not expecting that. Is that four? Well, it's after correction, so 32 out of 36. And what's that? Is that what percentage? Bashit yo. Yeah. Whoa. All right. All right. All right. pretty happy with that. I'm going to be honest. If I got anything in that ballpark on the actual exam, I'd be thrilled. Okay. Well, let's go find the mistakes. This one, I went D, could be B, could be C. It was A. Tai Kwong Miola. Okay, so. Okay, An Quan Xing, You Dai Ti Gao. Sorry, I read the wrong answer. We're doing two. A, Urumqi is Xinjiang's capital. Okay, did they say that? I'm not familiar with the word capital. It's like, it is, I was expecting Shenghui. Capital here. Head capital of a, is that it? It's Shoufu for places like Xinjiang and Neimongu. I use Shenghui. Let's ask ChatGPT. We'll go see if ChatGPT is ready. Hey, can you help? Shengfen and Shoufu. So Shengfen, I meant Shenghui. Shenghui. Not Shengfen. Shenghui 是指 中国 各省级行 政区的首府城市 capital of an autonomous region. So autonomous region 在中国每个省份的首府 通常也是该省份的政治、经济和文化中心。 北京是中国的首都 也是北京市的首府。 So this is like a... alright. Okay, so I knew that Urumqi was the capital of Xinjiang province. However, beyond that, what do I know? What? I guess I just got confused with the word. Did they actually say it? Let's read it. Let's give it a read. Did they actually say that Urumqi is the capital of Xinjiang province? Or are we just supposed to know this from background knowledge? 7月份新疆出现异常高温天气. Yeah, okay, so we're talking about the weather. 大部分地区最高气温在 35摄氏度以上, 没问题. 一些地区的最高气温为 40摄氏度以上. 首府, there it is, Urumqi. 首府, Urumqi. 14日 最高气温达到 40.6摄氏度, 突破近30年来 最高气温历史极值。 吐鲁番地区最高气温达到 46.2摄氏度。 Yeah, I remember from like geography or something, studying Chinese geography, that Xinjiang has some particularly places that get particularly hot. I can't believe I got that wrong. I've been there. I've been to Urumqi. Okay. I got six wrong. No, I got that one wrong because I didn't really understand Shoufu. I got 是省会，省会 and 首府 got them mixed up. Six was the interview. So the answer was A. I remember not fully understanding this. 没有不爱吃的食物 Okay, so he likes to eat anything. So the foodie, he was a foodie. He liked to eat. So are there really no foods that he doesn't like to eat? Where did he say that? Well, 不挑食, is it that one? Am I supposed to infer it from that? 我不挑食 means I'm not fussy. 我的优点是就是不挑食。Yeah, I think that's it. That's what I mean to infer it from. But saying you're not fussy doesn't imply you eat all every food. Every food imaginable. I'm sure there's something. 没有不爱吃的食物. It's not even you are willing to eat every type of food there is. You will even love eating it. So even like, I don't know.Just rubbish food as well. No, I somewhat dispute this. Like, a foodie is generally, like, sure, they like food, they eat lots of different types of food, maybe they're not that fussy as well, but they prefer good food over rubbish. Like, you're not going to just eat bland rice, plain rice or something. All right, anyway. 10, I chose C, the answer is D. Also this interview. I chose C, the answer is D. 戏中男的不让女演员吃零食。Really? I thought they did eat the junk food. So here's the play.When do we start talking about junk food? 就喜欢吃一些零食和水果之间的东西。可是在戏里我是教官总操练他们尤其不允许他们吃零食。Yeah, all right. That's it. That's the answer.Okay. No, I got that one wrong, fair and square. I just missed it. 不允许他们吃零食。And then, yeah, the Nanda is the person who's speaking. It's not, I was in, yeah, okay. And this grammar one, yeah. So this...Let's go ask this one, because this I got right, but I could have gotten it right for the wrong reasons. Let's look at Google it. Because I think the answer is it's 最啪啪之一. Okay, 中大夫卫生室，卫生室是镇里最中。So this is the sentence. Yeah, I've encountered this problem before, but I remember it from last time.I remember reading this article. 最啪啪之一的用法正确吗? Yeah, I remember reading this, and they listed like a whole bunch of papers at the end, and it's like, yeah. Here, read all those papers, and you will know if 最啪啪之一 counts as 鱼病. The problem is, everyone uses 最啪啪之一 So I think it's not reasonable to ask like students like me this sort of thing. Yeah, there it is on there. So, all right. I just want to show you. 对好的朋友. GE. This sort of thing. 对我最好的朋友GE,对吗? You can do this one, right? Yeah. 是我最好的朋友GE. So this is the problem. There's all these native speakers using this. And it's very unsatisfying when your textbook has examples like this and you're somehow meant to judge native speaker level errors as correct slash incorrect. I have encountered this before. I have also encountered 最啪啪GE in other textbooks counting as correct. Yeah. So that's the problem, isn't it? Like one textbook 最啪啪GE counts as an error, and in another textbook 最啪啪GE counts as a non-error. So that's a problem. They're inconsistent with one another as well. Anyway, I got 20 wrong. I chose A. The error is B. 写论文不仅要，而且会。 Ah! Oh, okay, the error is very obvious now. Yeah, 不仅要，而且会。就这个。 So it should be 不仅要，而且要会借助。 Yeah. 我不仅，而且不仅也的会 need to get rid of. That's the error, right? 写论文不仅要驳错误的观点，而且会。 No, this should be 要. These are not really compatible. I think that's the error. Let's Google it. See if the internet agrees with my 论点. 写论文不仅 要驳错误的观点. This one. So some students asked it on here. Okay, 先人. Sorry, this is it. What is this? What? That's... So where's the answer? Is there no answer? 田园种树. What? Alright, that didn't help very much. But that's the same post, right? And these are just the textbook, all right? So Google didn't help very much either. That's another problem with this kind of exercise. It's like, it just says, that's wrong, but they don't explain why it's wrong. Yeah, it's not very helpful. If you can't explain why it's wrong, you really shouldn't. I don't know. If I was writing a textbook, I'd be much too embarrassed to just say the answer is X without actually explaining it and pointing out why the student should learn this. All right. That's it. I got four of them wrong. And that one I kind of contest. But the rest I got wrong fair and square. All right. Thank you for watching. Remember to like and subscribe and leave comments and like... And comment about how annoying 最啪啪GE is. In some textbooks, it counts as a grammar error, and in other textbooks, they use it as if it's not a grammar error. Yeah, I think Yeah, if you see 对 plus plus 之一 as a grammar error, as listed in the grammar error section, and there's no others, that could be it. But I don't know. It depends who wrote the sentence as to whether or not it counts as a grammar error. Depends on who's judging. Anyway, I'll see you all next time. Bye bye.